guys, it's me Soda. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm back with another TikTok video. We're gonna watch some TikToks together that you guys have sent me over the past few months or so, and I'm gonna review them with you guys. Whether that's good TikToks or bad TikTok. Is this the first one of the year? I think it is. I did a good TikTok video at the start of the year, which was just good ones, but I think this is the first one of the year where I'm doing both. Alright, here's my TikTok account if you want to follow me or tag me in anything. I do occasionally post TikToks. Let's see what you guys have been saying to me. I've been saving some TikToks for a bit from you guys. It's been a little bit since I've actually looked at them. And did I just touch bird poo already? Nope, I didn't. It was just water. Okay, we're good.
I let my cockatoo watch TV. He thinks he's part of the movie. How cute.
This is so cute. Aww. Oh my god, that's the cutest thing. The way he's putting his wings up is so cute. Cockatiels are my favorite dragon. Okay, I got tagged in this one a lot. What is it doing? Okay, I'm kind of laughing at this one, but I'm also kind of like not laughing at it, but I am also laughing at it because I'm just so confused at what the cat is even doing. There's just so much going on. Like, why is it just like, what is this? What is it doing? Why is it like half swimming? What is happening? I've never seen a cat do this. What's it doing? And then the cat was like surprised that it fell in. Like, what are you expecting? But more seriously, this fish tank. What is this fish tank? This is so weird. What is going on? Why is it so slim? Like, I'm just confused about this whole layout of this tank. It just looks really weird. It's very, very slim. So like, it kind of looks like it might be big, but then you realize that it's actually super slim. So it's not actually big. I wonder how many like gallons this is, because it probably is not much to what it looks like. Definitely looks way too small for those fish. Are they goldfish or are they koi? I think it's both, honestly. I think it's got goldfish and koi in there. Jesus Christ. Why? I definitely wouldn't put koi in there at all. I think koi just need to be in a pond, to be honest. But surprisingly, this tank looks clean, but it's got like nothing in it too. So it's just kind of like a boring environment for fish. Like no plants or anything. Although I think they're in the middle of cleaning it. I think that's what this is. That's probably why it looks clean. But usually I bet this tank would get dirty really fast because of how many fish are in there. Yeah, this would get so dirty. I don't know how you'd even keep a stable cycle with this many fish. There'd be a big bio load going on in there. But like, it's also like, why are you just like letting your cat do this? I've seen a couple of TikToks like this where people let their cats like fall into their fish tanks. I just wouldn't do that personally. Because it's stressful for the fish and stressful for your cat. It's better to not encourage your cat to sit on your fish tank like this. But then whenever I say that, I get a lot of comments telling me that you just gotta let cats learn the hard way, and I personally don't agree with that. Each to their own, I guess, but definitely wouldn't encourage your cat to like harass your fish, you know. But I don't know about you, but personally I would probably not film it. I would probably remove the cat before they fall in, but you know, it makes a good TikTok.
Oh,
this one's funny.
Oh, he's backing up. Oh, man.
What the fuck?
Oh, he's backing up. Oh.
Why? Why did he do that? What is happening? He was pretty close though. Like, that is determination. Impressive jump, honestly. I didn't know rats could jump that high. But I have actually seen a couple of TikToks of them doing it, so I guess it's not uncommon, but it's just like, it's kind of cool, you know? I think we forget sometimes how smart rats actually are. They are very smart. This one has 19 million views. That's insane. I know this is gonna be bad because I've seen videos like this. It looks cute right now. Cute little tank. Never mind. It's not cute anymore. I was gonna say maybe put some shrimp in it. Shrimp might be okay. A couple of shrimp, but nope, we put what kind of fish are those? Are they just guppies or mollies? I don't currently tell. That's a lot of them though. Which is filled up to the top, by the way. They can jump out of that so easily. That's too small for fish. True. They replied, baby fish. I mean, those aren't babies though. They might be young fish, but they're not babies. For some reason on TikTok at the moment, there's a lot of accounts like this that just post these like aesthetic looking like little aquarium things. I think usually they're just like ads. They're companies that like sell plants or the tanks or something like that. And this is their way of like advertising that. But these videos, I find them really annoying because they often encourage people to put fish in these small aquariums and are kind of encouraging this idea that like, all you need is plants and the fish will be fine. You don't need filtration if you have plants and whatever, which sometimes can be true, but usually not, and there's a lot more to it than that. But at the end of the day, if the tank's this size, then it's like too small for any fish anyway. This would be cute without fish though. But I think that's kind of their thing. I feel like they do it on purpose to piss people off because it gets more attention that way. I don't know. Oh, is that goldfish? Oh no.
It's a 1, 2, 3. Run or cut down your Christmas tree.
This is cute. This is cool. No! Whoa, that went so fast. Okay, whoa. This actually looks super cool. Like, the effort put into this, I respect. And then they just ruin it by putting goldfish in there. Look at these goldfish, are they even alive? This little landscape thing looks cool, but there's not enough water in there for honestly like any fish. If you want to make a cool aquascape in a small fish tank, don't add fish to it. You can still do it without fish. You could even possibly put snails in it. This one I think would be fine with snails, maybe shrimp. Stop! This is not their audio, by the way. This is just random audio. It may be a playing motion, I don't know. But even then, like, it doesn't look that violent. Maybe it's just playing with it, but I still wouldn't let a cat play with a bird because even if the cat's not trying to hurt the bird, they still can very easily. And yeah, sometimes they can actually get along fine, but I still don't think it's a good idea to risk it, especially like with cats and stuff, because cats have bacteria in their claws and in their mouths that can kill birds really fast, so it's just not a good idea. I need somebody to hear. I don't know why this like even is a TikTok. Like, it has like sad music in the background. Like, do they know it's a bad thing, or I don't know, like, I don't know the context. But I'm very against clipping birds' wings. As you guys probably know, I've talked about it quite a lot. I go into more detail about it in other videos. How about don't get a pet that flies if you don't want a pet to fly? Exactly. Like, that's what I don't understand. Like, if you don't want your bird to fly, then why do you get a bird? Like, honestly, sure, I might get some people in the comments telling me like, oh, I'm scared my bird's gonna smack into a window, or I'm worried it's gonna fly outside. But that's like your responsibility of being a bird owner, is to like make sure that doesn't happen. Which obviously accidents can happen, but that's why you can like recall train your bird. That's just kind of my thoughts. I think it's like kind of selfish to clip your bird's wings. Which sounds, I feel kind of bad saying it, but it's like, it's the truth. That's how I genuinely feel. If your bird is flying into walls and stuff, they will learn to stop doing that. You don't have to clip their wings so they can't fly ever again, you know? Which clipping wings does grow back, but it can do like permanent damage to like their wing muscles and like their mental state. So it's just not worth that risk to me. And I don't know why this video has so many likes, just someone clipping their bird's wings. Is it supposed to be satisfying? Is that what it is? Cause like, this is not satisfying at all to me. This just shows how kind of horrible it is to take away their ability to fly. Plus they cut them so low as well. Even if you do cut birds' wings, which you shouldn't, you don't cut them like all the way like this. Another thing, sorry if I'm talking about this too long, but I just want to make this clear because I know probably we'll get comments about it. If you do clip your birds' wings because you're worried about them flying away, they can still get away. I've seen so many birds go missing that have clipped wings. They can actually still fly a bit even if their wings are clipped, and they can still catch a gust of wind and get blown away. But it does mean they might have a less chance of surviving because they will easily get caught by a predator. So like, what even is the point, you know? I don't know, I just don't find any reason for it. Okay. I didn't watch this whole video. But I have seen similar videos, unfortunately. Why? 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 Why did this become a thing? And there was like one video. Was it the same account? I don't know. Of someone putting a fish under a cat, which I already talked about. And they're just still doing it. Now thankfully this cat seems pretty chill, But like, what if the cat moved? The fish are just gonna flop onto the floor and die. Why do they even bother putting rocks in it? These poor fish. But this is really stressful for these fish. Like, I don't know how you can just have like no regard for the fish at all. This is just so unnecessarily mean for these poor fish. Do you think they have outtakes where the like cat moves and the fish fall off? Okay, these are really cool. I just wanted to show this one. I think I already talked about this account because I think these are really cool. They're called Gracious Sirens. But the video caption thing says when they found out how big an axolotl can get. And because of that, I got a lot of people tagging me in this being like, is that true? But they actually do say in the caption here that they're greater sirens, distant cousins to the axolotls. I think they just did that to be funny and people took it very seriously, which usually happens on TikTok to be honest, but no, they're not actually axolotls like this person said themselves. They are greater sirens. They do look pretty similar though in the face. Well, kind of. The faces are longer, but they have like similar like gills and like hands and stuff, but their faces look pretty different as well, I think. These are really cool though. You do not see these pets very often. They are so cool. It would be really fascinating if axolotls did turn into that, but they do not. Imagine if you just wake up one day and your axolotl turns into this worm axolotl. There actually are a lot of animals that look similar to axolotls. This is not the only one. There are many that people mistake for axolotls. No. So anyways, it's my fish now. He wants to see the new tank. Thank God. Ugh, that's gotta suck. Oh my God, it is a beta fish. No, in a giant like wine glass. Jesus Christ. I hate it when that happens. When like a family member gets an animal and don't take the best care of it. Very awkward situation. I wanna see their new tank though. Can you show it to me? Oh my God. This is... Yes! This is so much better. They're cycling it too. Oh my God. I love you. Thank goodness. Oh my gosh. Looks so much better. We love to see it. Good on you. This is so fucking cute. Ponyo is also like my favorite Studio Ghibli movie. Just saying. It's a very good movie. This is so cute. I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna cry. Curtis watching his favorite movie. Oh, he's so cute. Oh, I wish we could get African dwarf frogs here in New Zealand. This tank also looks very nice. Like, I feel very calm watching this. I would watch like a whole like hour long video of him just watching Ponyo. Curtis movie night. Oh my God, that's so cute. Oh, he's so cute. I love him. All right, guys, I'm gonna end the video here. We saw a lot of interesting TikToks today. Let me know in the comments what you thought about any of the TikToks that we watched today. And as always, if you want to send me any, feel free to tag me in anything on TikTok, whether that's good videos or bad videos. I would love to see them and I might review them in my next video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!